Then the jet banked suddenly at a right angle and started descending quickly toward the runway. I heard the noise of the jet engines from the airport terminal where we waited. It was so loud, I worried about how scary an experience it must be for my dog, spending so many dark hours traveling in a wooden crate in the back of a plane with the loud noise of jet engines. I continued to watch as the jet landed smoothly. I saw passengers disembark down a tunnel that was connected to the jet at the terminal, and then I saw workmen begin to unload cargo from the back of the jet. They unloaded a large wooden crate using a forklift. "See? I bet that's the box with my dog inside," I declared.
"Come on, Luke. We better go and ask at the airport desk. You might just be right. The plane is due about now,"
said Dad. The airport was busy. People rushed by hauling suitcases for foreign holidays, and business people dressed in fancy suits and carrying briefcases. "Can we travel on a jet to go on holiday someday?" I asked Dad. But he was too busy looking at the large screens with different destinations and departure and arrival times flashing across the screen to hear my question. "Which airline is Benson traveling on?" I said.
"Let me double check the paperwork. Delta Flight 801,
said Dad. "Look, there it is on the board. It says that Flight 801 has arrived," I announced with excitement.
"Okay, let's find somebody to help us find your dog," replied Dad with a sigh.
Next, we found the right line for filing out the arrival paperwork so we could collect Benson and joined a short queue. Dad handed me all the travel information for Benson, and then he walked off to buy a coffee from a newsstand. I didn't have to wait long before the queue cleared, and a lady behind the desk asked me, "How can I help you, sir?"